Voters will be asked to decide on a half-cent sales tax on November 6th with ballot question number 14. The public asks, why a sales tax increase? Infrastructure backlog from 2016 still exists or is worse. We don't use general fund dollars for roads. The recession has resulted in over $1 billion of deferred new construction and maintenance, new road construction and repaving, sidewalks and water quality improvements. These funds will improve the quality of life, public safety, safer roads, bridges and sidewalks, cleaner waterways. What are the benefits of a sales tax versus a property tax? You get to share the burden. Visitors will contribute 15 to 20%. Everyone who uses our roads, sidewalks, and rivers will help pay, not just residents and property owners. It's important to remember that ad valorem property taxes are 100% paid by property owners. With a sales tax, we share the burden, and our visitors and anyone who comes into the county gets to share in this burden. Why can't the city use the money that is already raised? Most funds are specific purpose. Roads, bridges, and culverts funded out of gas tax revenues have been declining or stagnant as costs continue to rise. Gas tax is maximized and insufficient, so there are no additional dollars available. That is because most people will assume as gas prices go up, the funds increase. No, the reason that this is actually insufficient is because gas tax is pennies on the gallon. So regardless of the amount it costs per gallon, it stays the same that we receive on the gas tax. And if anything, cars are more efficient and using less and less gas, which means less and less gallons, therefore the funds are at a standstill. Funding roads, bridges, and culverts out of the general fund would result in service reductions elsewhere. How does this tax increase compare to other counties, and how long will it be for? Half cent for 10 years is the proposed tax increase. Currently, St. Lucie County is at 6.5 cents. Palm Beach, Indian River, Brevard, and Okeechobee counties are currently at 7 cents. Martin is currently at 6 cents and has tried twice to raise it to another cent. The sales tax would only apply to the first $5,000 of a large purchase, such as boats and cars. Any large ticket item, it would only again apply to the first $5,000. And the cost to the average family would be about $50 per year. So how much money will be raised and how will the money be split? The estimated annual revenue for St. Lucie County is $9.2 million. For Port St. Lucie, $7.5 million. For Fort Pierce, $1.8 million. St. Lucie Village, $25,000. For a total annual revenue of $18.5 million, translating over the estimated 10 years, that would be $108 million to St. Lucie County, $88 million to Port St. Lucie, $21 million to Fort Pierce, $300,000 to St. Lucie Village for a total revenue estimated of $217 million. How did the city determine what projects would receive these funds? Funds must be exclusively allocated for capital projects. Roads, sidewalks, and water quality projects benefiting the Indian River Lagoon and the St. Lucie River. Projects came at the request of our citizens. City Council selected the list after surveying residents in a statistically valid survey. So our residents chose the projects, which will begin with the first one, St. Lucie West Boulevard, with an allocation of $13.2 million, which would improve the intersections at Cashmere, allocating specifically $500,000 for that. Intersection at California, $2 million allocated. Intersection at Peacock, $300,000. And the intersection at Bayshore, $400,000. And the California widening would receive $10 million allocation. Another important part of the project list is sidewalks, with an estimated $11 million allocated. Additional funding provided by the sales tax would allow the construction of 35 miles or 100% of the sidewalks listed in the master plan over the next 10 years to be completed. Repaving would receive $27.5 million, the bulk of it going citywide and in particular allocation to Gatlin Boulevard. Traffic signal coordination would receive $1.7 million, and that would be for Port St. Lucie Boulevard and Crosstown Parkway. Floresta Drive would receive an allocation of $25 million, which would include the three different sections of South Bend to Elkham, Elkham to Crosstown, and Crosstown to Prima Vista. Torino intersections would receive $2 million, and that would go towards the improvement on the California Roundabout and the Cashmere Roundabout. And finally, the US 1 improvements would receive $1.5 million. The completion of landscape and irrigation improvements along US 1 would provide for a much needed beautification and enhancement of the city's gateways, commercial district, and could help spark economic development in our community. All of these projects that you have seen are detailed on our website, and you can learn more by going to www.cityofpsl.com and search for the sales tax. Better roads, more sidewalks, and cleaner rivers. With the sales tax, it's important to remember that every dollar stays here. Visitors will contribute 15 to 20%. It won't apply to all purchases, and there will be four layers of protection. A local citizen oversight committee will be formed. Florida law ensures the money can only be used for project areas listed on the ballot. The local ordinance will define where the money will go, and local elected officials will make these decisions. It is very important for you to understand the sales tax, how it will look on the ballot, and to not to forget to turn your ballot around because it will be on the back of the ballot. To learn more, I invite you to visit any one of the websites listed, www.slchalfcent.org or pslhalfcent.org or fphalfcent.org. Better roads, more sidewalks, and cleaner rivers for St. Lucie County.